What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos Silencer, and welcome back. And today we're going to talk a little bit about Black Ops 2 Zombies. And the gameplay you're watching is from Tamok. The dude supplies a lot of gameplays for me when I need them. I don't even know what Moab he gets, but it's a 4 or 5 minute Moab with whatever gun that is on the screen. Because when the dude plays, he gets a Moab. And I want to talk about Black Ops 2 Zombies. The last video I did on Zombies was talking about the fact that Treyarch is probably going to make it where we can have an 8-player zombie mode, where you can have 7 teammates with you, which just totally opens up the ideas of strategies that we're going to be able to do, and the maps are probably going to be bigger. To hold 8 people in a game mode or a match, even on Zombies, you're going to have pretty good sized maps, I would think. And it's going to get to the point where I'm assuming, like, let's say wave 20, you remember how many zombies were coming with 4 people. Think about wave 20 with 8 people. It's going to make it challenging, because instead of having 4 people have to cooperate and work together as a team, which sometimes is hard when you're playing with randoms, you're going to have 8. But if you have an 8-man team of buddies and you guys party up and you're ready to go, it should be a lot of fun. And it's going to be cool because they're going to be using the same type of engine as the multiplayer, so there's going to be a lot of new things that they're able to incorporate in there. Like, for instance, like Modern Warfare 3 Survival Mode will get the same maps. Like Black Ops 2 should be able to do the maps. For instance, a multiplayer map we have in Black Ops 2 can also be a Zombies map, which is going to be pretty cool. And I wanted to talk real quick about an idea that I have. We all know the Pack-a-Punch machine, and we all know you upgrade it and you get these silvery decaled, beautiful weapons with usually extended mags, and they have a lot more kick to them. They shoot purple fizzy piss powder out the barrel, and they sound really cool. I'm thinking that wouldn't it be cool if we had some type of attachment machine? Now, it could either be connected to the Pack-a-Punch, or it could be separate on its own, but it goes into this idea that everybody's talking about, how that Call of Duty Black Ops 2 Zombies is going to be a lot more customizable, as in you'll be able to customize your characters, which would be insane, very cool, especially to get new stuff and unlock like different outfits and stuff like that. But on top of that, to be able to customize your guns. So I'm thinking that if we had some type of custom attachment machine, that would be really cool. For instance, you get an M16, okay, and you're using it, and you don't have enough money to get it Pack-a-Punched, because 5,000 was a lot to get Pack-a-Punched if you're playing serious and you've got 8 people. Obviously, the points are going to be a lot higher probably for killing zombies, but anyway, you want to use this M16, but you don't have enough money to get it Pack-a-Punched. So you can go spend 500 or 1,000 and go to the attachment machine and get yourself extended mags or dual mags, or get yourself a red dot sight, or a grip, or an underbarrel shotgun, or an underbarrel flamethrower. You could use all kinds of different options and add attachments to your guns as you go, as you work your way up to that Pack-a-Punch. If they even bring back the Pack-a-Punch, we don't even know if they're going to, but if they did, this would be a really cool interlude to that, because that's what everybody does. You automatically go, and your goal is to get your guns Pack-a-Punch, but it takes a while in between there, so this gives you an option to upgrade your guns and keep things interesting as you go towards that goal, if they have Pack-a-Punch. Let me know what you guys think about that. I think it'd be pretty cool. I don't think it'd be that hard to put in. Maybe give the option for each gun 2 attachments. Of course, depending on if it's a pistol or an SMG or LMG or sniper rifle, the attachments are going to vary. But given the option to get 2 attachments, I'd love to just, example, get the ACR and throw on some dual mags where I can reload quicker, and then throw on a red dot sight. And maybe if they have that daiquiri thing where I can, that headshot daiquiri thing, or something like an underbarrel shotgun for when you run out of that main clip on the ACR, you can switch to the master key type shotgun and keep it going. The options are endless. They could do so much with it. I think it's a good idea. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. And if you're excited about Zombies 8-player multiplayer type platform engine, I'm pretty stoked. I think it, along with the multiplayer, it looks to me like they're building this from the ground up. I think this is going to be a whole new engine. I don't think this is going to be the feel of Black Ops. I don't think this is going to be the feel of Modern Warfare at all. I think they're going for something new. And they're also wanting to get into the e-gaming scene, so I think they're going to make this where it's really enjoyable for spectators and viewers as well. So let me know, guys. As always, thank you for watching the video. Be sure to rate and comment on it. And up on the screen right now, I popped up two videos for you guys' viewing pleasure. The first one is Best Friends Trolled on Xbox. I played in a match. Actually, I played in a lobby the other day, and these two guys, these two clan mates, were so annoying. They just kept on and on bitching and griping about everything, so I decided to spice it up a little bit. You guys should enjoy that. And the other one is a pistol breakdown on the Chris Card pistol from the trailer of Black Ops 2. You guys make sure to check that out. That's it.